Hey everyone, welcome back to Bio School. In today's session, we are going to learn about supplementary gene interaction. So in my previous video, we have discussed what is complementary gene interaction. So I'll drop the link in the description box of this video. So please make sure to check out that video too. So let's get started and understand what is supplementary gene interaction. I will explain you with examples. So guys, please stay tuned till the end of this video. So let's begin. So supplementary gene interaction, it is also a type of non-allelic gene interaction. I do have a video on gene interaction and its type where I have explained what is non-allelic gene interaction. Okay, let's say there are the two genes are present. One gene is A and other gene is B. And for the A gene, there are two alleles. One is capital A, small a is the second allele. Similarly, here the capital B is one allele and small b is another allele for the gene B. So non-allelic gene interaction means the allele of one gene, it interact with allele of other gene. That is the non-allelic gene interaction. Okay, so the supplementary gene interaction is also a type of non-allelic gene interaction. In non-allelic gene interaction, you will find there is a deviation of dihybrid cross ratio. What is the dihybrid cross ratio? It is 9:3:3:1, right? So in any type of non-allelic gene interaction, that will result in deviation of dihybrid cross ratio. So now we'll learn about the supplementary gene interaction and what it says. And in supplementary gene interaction, we'll see how the dihybrid cross ratio is deviated. So what is the supplementary gene interaction is about? The supplementary gene interaction, it says that they are two independent genes. Supplementary genes are two independent genes present on different loci of same or different chromosome. They produce their own trait, but when the genes interact in dominant state, produce a new trait. Supplementary genes are the independent genes. They present on the different loci and they produce their own trait. But when the dominant form of these independent genes, they interact, dominant form of the genes, okay, focus on the word dominant, okay, when the dominant form of these genes, independent genes, they interact, then that will result in formation of a new trait. So here in supplementary gene interaction, usually the one gene, it expresses its trait independently, okay. But the other gene, here we are talking about the dominant form of the gene. But other dominant gene has no expression. It has its no expression. But when both the genes are present in dominant form and interact with each other, that will result in a new trait. This is about the supplementary gene interaction. The dominant form of one gene, it will express its character independently, but the other dominant gene, it has no expression. But when both the dominant genes, they present together, then that results in a new trait. Okay, so let's understand this by taking an example. So example is coat color in mice. Coat color in mice, let's say the gene, dominant form of one gene, that is capital B, it will produce its own trait, okay, independently. That is, let's say it produces its own trait, that is black color. Other dominant form of gene, that is A, has no expression. No expression, that means it will produce a albino mice. Albino mice means it is a white color mice, okay. But when both the dominant genes, they present together, it will produce a new trait. That new trait is known as agouti. Agouti form of mice, these are the brown color mice. Okay, let's have a look on this one, the completely white. So this one is albino mice. Okay, albino coat color mice, and this one, it is a black coat color mice, and this one is the golden brownish color mice. It is known as the agouti coat color mice. Okay, so the black color, it will be produced by the dominant form of one gene, that is capital B, and albino color, it will be produced by another dominant form of gene which has no expression. Okay, one gene has the no expression, that means it results in the white color mice, which is called the albino. But when these two dominant form of genes, they present together and interact with each other, that results in a new trait, that is agouti. Okay, this is all about the supplementary gene interaction is. Okay, so let's cross. We have to find out the phenotypic ratio in F2 generation in order to see the whether it deviate from the dihybrid cross or not. Of course it will deviate from the dihybrid cross, but we have to find out the ratio of supplementary gene interaction, capital B, small a, with small b, capital A. Okay, so the capital B, it will express a trait, that is black color, and here the dominant form of gene A is present. It has no expression, that means it is albino. Okay, then it will produce gamete. It will be capital B small a, here small b capital A. Okay, so it will produce 4 gametes. It will also produce 4 gametes. So in the F1 generation, you will get capital A, capital B, small b. Okay, and how many progenies? It is a dihybrid cross. It is the 16 progenies will be produced in F1 generation, and all are heterozygous. Can you please tell me what is the phenotype, what is the coat color of mice in F1 generation? Your both the dominant genes are present. That means it is agouti, right? Now we'll self cross A, B with A, B. The F1 generation product. So it will produce the gametes A, B, A, B, a, B. Here also same 4 different type of gametes, A, B. A, b, a, b, a, b. Then let's draw the Punnett square. Okay, so first we'll look where both the dominant form of genes are present. Okay, let me write down here. If A gene is present alone, then it will produce albino. Okay, independently. Similarly, B gene, if it is present, then it will also produce its own trait, that is black. But when both the genes, they present together, then it will produce a new trait. That new trait is known as agouti. So let's see where both the dominant form of genes are present. See here, both the dominant form of genes are present. So always the dominant form of genes, they are present in this direction, like all the dominant form of both the genes, they will present like this direction always. Okay, so both the dominant form of genes are present, so that will produce the agouti, and it is brown color. So let me write down how many is 9. Then black color, that means only the capital B is present. Okay, and A is small. Look at here. Capital form of B is present. It will express its trait, that is black. Similarly, over here also and here. So how many black color? Black color is 3. Then next is albino. Albino means only the capital A is present and B is in small form. So this one, albino. This one is also albino because A is dominant but B is small. It's okay, albino. And look at here. Here all are in small form. That means no expression, so it will also result in albino. So this one is 4. So the phenotypic ratio for supplementary gene interaction is 9:3:4. And what is the dihybrid cross ratio? Dihybrid cross ratio is 9:3:3:1. Look at here. Here the dihybrid cross ratio is deviated. So here the 9 is 9, then 3, 3, and the last 2, they are added together. So it is 4. So you have to remember what is the phenotypic ratio of supplementary gene interaction. This is 9:3:4. Okay. So if you know the dihybrid cross ratio, then simple 9:3:2, first 2, then the last 2 you will add. So it will be 9:3:4. So in the complementary gene interaction, the ratio is 9:7. So in complementary gene interaction, last 3 are added up. Okay, but in supplementary, last 2 of dihybrid cross are added. So this is a trick to remember the ratio of complementary and supplementary gene interaction. If you want to know in details about complementary gene interaction, then I do have a video on that. So please go through that video. If you like this video, then please do share with your friends and don't forget to subscribe my channel. So bye bye, see you in my next video. Till then, keep learning.